river, in Pharaoh's house, and the wilderness. Jesus, come on somebody, was processed in the wilderness for 40 days, a day for each year Israel was in the wilderness. Sometimes you will be processed in the wilderness. Sometimes you will be processed in a pit. Sometimes you will be processed in a prison. Sometimes you will be processed in the lion's den. Sometimes you will be processed in a fiery furnace. Sometimes you will be processed in a garden, because that's where God grows things and grows people. Adam was processed in a garden. Jesus had to process his will in the Garden of Gethsemane. And if he did not process his will in the Garden of Gethsemane, we would never have seen Calvary. Come on, somebody. It can be, you can be processed. Somebody say process. It can be through circumstances or even circumcision, biblically speaking. God, watch this, in his sovereignty, can not only process you in any environment he wants to, but he can use anyone. I feel glory. He wants to. He can use your mother. He can use your father. He can use your siblings, co-workers, and guess what? He can use church folk. I'm coming today. He can use even the devil if he desires. You don't believe me? He told the devil, "Have you not considered my servant Job?" Job was processed because God bragged on Job. Hallelujah. He can do whatever he wants to do. Process is difficult, and I'm just trying to substantiate and just lay a foundation of process as we lead to the life of Joseph. I want to look at his process. I know he says, and we all hear the words of spiritual folk, you know. We hear a person say, "I'll ride or die for Jesus," right? We say, "For God I live and for God I die." And we hear in Joseph's word language, we hear him say, "What man meant for evil, God meant it for good." But I want to look at his process, because process is difficult. If you don't have the right, watch this, perspective, process is hard and painful. It refines your cravings, appetite, spiritual diet, your focus, and your character. God is not about you just fulfilling your destiny, but it's through the pursuit and process of destiny that God makes you more like his son. We are being conformed to the image of his son. Process is the wheel that the master potter, Jesus, God, uses to shape you, mold you, yes, break you, and build you. And sometimes you don't have the right perspective about your process. Watch this. You will abort the process, attempt to modify the process. Come on, somebody. We all got our vices when we're trying to just numb the pain of the process. Can I talk to real people this morning? You shop, you do all kinds of stuff, but we ain't gonna go there yet. We attempt to modify the process. You will choose to settle with something less strenuous. But there's a danger in attempting to modify or abort the process. Because when you modify the process, you modify your ability to operate in purpose. I feel the glory of God. That's why James tries to encourage us to consider it all joy. I feel glory in here. My brethren, when you enter various trials, diverse temptation, when you are dealing with a diversity of trials. How many of you know that you're not just dealing with one thing? I'm dealing with a diversity of stuff. Stuff on my left, stuff on my right, stuff from my past, and stuff that's trying to hinder me from my future. But in the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that I will be everything that the Lord wants me to be. I will consider it all joy when I go through trial. Watch this, knowing that the testing of your faith provides endurance. There's something that happens when you're being processed. It provides something for you. And let endurance have its perfect work, a perfect result, perfect work. Here's a purpose clause, so that you may be perfect. Hallelujah. And complete, lacking nothing. When you're not processed, you lack something. I know it's hard. You're sitting there right now kind of uncomfortable because you are now coming to the reality of your process. You're thinking about all the things you've gone through, all the things you had to deal with, the abandonment, the pain, the fear, all the anxieties. Who did this? Who did what? The church hurt. All those kinds of things. And you're coming to the realization that you have been processed. Yes, Lord. Romans says, and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are called according, watch this, to his purpose. If you got purpose, you got a process. And the text says, Joseph, he says, according to the NIV, you intended to harm me, but God intended it for good, to accomplish what is now being done, the saving of many lives. I also like how the Christian Standard writes it. It says, you plan evil against me. I'm trying to hold myself and behave this morning. God planned it for good. To bring out, watch this, the present result. The survival of many people. Just nudge your neighbor and say, neighbor, wake up. Yeah, it's not about you. God has a plan for you to touch lives. Come on, somebody. God has a plan to process you. Plans for your life to touch lives and to touch people. So let's just do a quick overview of Joseph. Joseph, he was the son of Israel. He's the son of Jacob. He was he received a coat of many colors and a ring. He was favored by his father. That father provoked some jealousy and conspiracy among the brothers. He had dreams. He not only had favor, but he began to have dreams. His father favored him, and then the dreams just made it worse. The Lord began to speak to him about his destiny. And my brothers and sisters, God will speak to you through dreams, whether it's visions, whether it's a prophet, a man of God, woman of God, about your destiny. That's why you can't miss a Sunday or miss a midweek service, because your pastor and the people of God, the leadership, are speaking over your life. The Bible says in Amos chapter 3 verse 7 that God does nothing, truly the Lord does nothing, unless he reveals it to his prophets. There's a plan. Man, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, but the prophet, the man of God, woman of God, has an understanding about your life and your future. He will give you revelation and insight about where you're going and where you're headed. And Joseph received a dream, and he saw in his dream that his family on two occasions in the dream, that his family bowed down. Now the interesting thing about this, pastor, is that in the end, it does not talk about rulership. It talks about the salvation of many people. So sometimes we might get a dream or a revelation or an insight, but we don't understand the totality of what it is until we begin to get processed. You're understanding better by and by. So he's dealing with betrayal now. They're conspiring against him. They take his coat. They put him in a pit. They sell him to the Midianites. Then the Midianites sell him to the Egyptians. And then he's in a prison. And then God gives him favor while he's in a prison. I need to pause parenthetically and tell somebody that you can be in unfavorable circumstances and still have the favor of God. And while he's in a prison, then he's put in certain responsibilities, working out his gift. Come on, somebody. He then is put over everything in Potiphar's house. And he's in Potiphar's house. Potiphar's house receives favor because of Joseph. And while Joseph is there, everything's going well. Then he then has temptation. Potiphar's wife tries to get with the man of God. He looked good. He was gifted. Come on, somebody. Talk to me. He was gifted, and there was a temptation. But he did not fall into temptation, and so he ran. He was stripped again of his clothes, and then he was running naked. I like how Pastor used to say, when I heard his word, he was naked but not ashamed. If you won't be naked, don't be ashamed. You should be running from something. Come on, somebody. And so he then is put in prison again. And while he's in prison, he runs into two brothers who are out of Pharaoh's house, and he uses his gift. In spite of all the things that's happened to him, he uses his gift, and he interprets their dreams, and then they remember him when they get released, and he then comes into Pharaoh's house, interprets his dreams, and then he's put over everything in Egypt. Somebody say promotion. But there gotta be a process. So let's look into this process. Y'all with me this morning? the jealousy, the conspiracy. I want to help somebody. Now we're getting ready to do some impartation because I can feel you in the spirit right now. You look good. You got money. You got some education, but you are dealing with the perspective, the struggle, and the wrestle, and the anxiety with your process. The jealousy, the conspiracy, the betrayal, that the lies. It was a vehicle to Joseph to get to Egypt to become what he dreamed. You can't choose to receive. You can choose to receive your calling. You can choose to take a job. You can choose to take responsibility. But let me help you. You cannot choose a vehicle to how to get there. There's going to be some things that's out of your control. Joseph, he was sold by his brothers to the Midianites. Then the Midianites sold him to Egypt, to Potiphar's house. He found himself in prison. Joseph was just handed over from one party to the next, one situation to the next, one culture to the next. He had no say and no control over what was taking place in his life. But watch this. He was in the right place at the right time. And I'm here to tell somebody, I know you don't understand it. Ain't nobody tell you anything. And you're going from one situation to the next, one hand to the next, one job to the next, one department to the next, one family to the next, one diagnosis to the next, one doctor to the next, one exam to the next. And I'm here to tell you, even though you're not in control, you're in the right place at the right time. You're being processed. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to get excited about being processed. I know it's hard. I know, but let me tell you, in this season, in some seasons, you don't need to be in control. You don't need to be in the driver's seat. You need to let God have his way. There's various types of steering in our vehicles now. They got all kinds of fancy stuff. They got the fast steering and all those other things. But there's a steering in the kingdom where it says no control. And you need to have no control in this season. And you need to allow God to move you the way he wants to move you, because he will never hurt you. He will never harm you. I know it hurts, but you gotta be like Job and say, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. When you are being processed, it will cause you to go through sudden abandonment. Yeah. Of old mentors. Yeah, hallelujah. It's sometimes geographical and sometimes sociological. Look at his story. Joseph had to leave home. God saw it in his divine sovereignty, in his omniscience, to move Joseph from his home under his father into Egypt under Potiphar and Pharaoh. He had to leave home and learn how to rule. He had a dream, but he had to learn how to rule in the favor of God. It's not by might nor by power, but by his spirit, saith the Lord. I know many people, they have great gifts. They've gone to school. They hold positions in the secular world. But the reality is, you must be processed in the things of the spirit. Corinthians says that the things of the spirit, they are spiritually discerned. And you gotta be processed in the things of God to be able to do the things of God. You can be gifted and talented and have all the degrees, but you must be processed in the spirit to do, handle, discern, and impart spiritual things. He had to leave. Yeah, many of you, I can see in the Holy Ghost that you had to move. Yeah, from one location to the next. He had to learn the responsibility of that environment through the prison system. Hallelujah. When he got to the palace in the season of famine, he wouldn't be culture shocked. He had to get processed through the prison. So when he got to the palace during famine, he wouldn't have a culture shock. Now, I was a CO back in the day. I was a correctional officer, and there's some restrictions that's in the prison system. There's some things that you don't have at your fingertips. It's restrictive. There's some things. There's some strict guidelines, vigorous rules, non-negotiable deadlines, and unpredictable authoritative personalities. And when you are dealing with people who is being processed or dealing with crisis, like the people that's going to be in the famine, you got to know how to respond, how to lead, and remain steadfast in the midst of their response to their uncertain faith. Everybody can't lead in
in crisis. Only processed people can. So he had to go through the prisons in Egypt to be processed in the DNA of that geographical location. Look at somebody and say, I gotta go. Yeah, this is going to be in this season as God is processing you. You're going to have to move. I know it don't feel good. You don't use uncertain about what is ahead of you. But you got to move. You got to transition. You got to go to the next place.
He was in the prison systems. Hallelujah. And he had to learn how to see the favor of God in his life. In a prison. Mm-hmm. That's a part of the process so he can have the boldness and watch this, a right memory to face the famine with that he was destined to preserve a people through. He had, while he was in prison, he saw the favor of God on his life. One thing that many processed people have to learn is just how to see God and God's favor on their lives when they are in an unfavorable situation. You got to know, if God's before me, who can be against me? No weapon formed against you shall prosper. They will form, they will come against you, and they will every once in a while hit you upside the head. But though you are not down, it's not a knockout. Process people know how to take a blow and roll with the punches. You're not afraid. You ain't sensitive. You got thick skin. And the reason why many of us like to quit a ministry when somebody say one thing to us is because you haven't been processed. You were elevated and promoted too early, and you need to sit down a while and be processed. Yes, sir. Look at somebody say, you got to be processed. You got to see the favor of God. I know it's bad, so look at your life right now. Look at what you came from. Come on, somebody. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. Didn't meet my father until I was 12. But I wouldn't change a thing because I know that he's the author. It's his story, right? And the finisher of my faith. And I thank him for all he's done for me. God had to process Joseph in Egypt. Somebody say Egypt. Now, while home is comfortable, it's not always conducive, watch this, to teach you what your purpose will require you to do. Home is comfortable, but it's not always conducive. It's not always beneficial to what your purpose will require of you. Your purpose will put a demand on you. There are some environments and atmospheres that support process, but there are some environments and atmospheres and relationships that are counterproductive to your particular process. That's why you had to go to school, God. You had to go train for a job. You had to go into another environment. And let me just pause parenthetically, because I know we do homeschooling now. But the thing about that is that you're changing the atmospheres and you're introducing another law that governs another space and bringing it and introducing it to yours. That's why I got to say this for my brother. All of you should come out to the conference, because there's other laws, 5-star laws, that's going to be coming introduced to you so you can be able to get the promotion. It's a part of your process. Whenever there's a meeting, whenever there's a conference, whenever there's a prayer meeting, come on somebody. There's too many. There's choir rehearsals have more members than intercessory prayer meetings. We need to be in the full process of the life of the church. So we're bringing persons in to introduce you to a new level, because you will never go to another level until you've been exposed to the laws that governs that level. Come on, preach, man. So that's why you got to go to another place. Like all my family, they're in the military and they go away in basic training. They go to another place because there's laws that govern that place, that space, that help you and to equip you to become what you're supposed to be. Now, not only does it geographically, it also does it sociologically. I feel we about to hit something in a minute. Remember I told you process deals with every angle of you? Yeah. Well, God will process you to deal with your appetites, cravings, behaviors, mentalities, and insecurities. Watch this. That connect to your genetic code. Yeah. Joseph could not be under his father because purpose and his future was calling. Sometimes God will make you abandon even the people you love, because it's not that a relationship at this time is not conducive for what God wants to process in you. Some people, God has taken many of you. I can see it. He is taking you from some great nurturers. Why? Because you did not need a certain level of nurturing while being processed. There's some things you needed to feel. I feel glory. You needed to feel some things in your character. You needed to feel some things in your emotions. You had to, because why? Processed people must be crucified. Yes, God, I'm a prophetic deliverance minister. And one of the things you have to go through, there's a difference in being delivered and being crucified, because you can't be delivered from your flesh, but you can crucify your flesh, and you got to go through some crucifying experience, because the more you get the nails, the more you get the thorns, the more you get the cross and the two wooden beams, you look more like him. The nails will make you more like him. The nails will make you pray. The nails will make you worship. Even in process.
Yeah. Let me hurry, because my time is about up. Joseph's father, Israel, a.k.a. Jacob, the trickster, con artist, the liar, his father, his grandfather, his great-grandfather, they were all liars. I'm going to help somebody. Watch this, because this messed me up. Isaiah lied about his wife being his sister to the men of Gerar. Abraham, watch me now, lied to Pharaoh about his wife being his sister. And Joseph, watch this, is processed in Egypt to stand with men that the men of his family could not stand before in truth. Y'all missed that. Abraham lied to Pharaoh about his wife being his sister. He was scared of Pharaoh and the very people Joseph's grandfather was scared of. Joseph had to stand next to. There's some things in your genetic code that have to be dealt with so you can stand where others had died. I'm here to tell somebody they died in temptation, died in fear, died in anxiety, and God is processing you so you can live beyond where they have died. You don't have to die in divorce. I'm working in here. You don't have to die being a liar. You don't gotta die in adultery. You don't gotta die in guilt and shame when you allow God to process you. Somebody shall process.
So he had to be processed. Process require you to transition from one mentor to another. Joseph's father loved his son. He loved his son. Let me cut across the field. Loved his son. Put a robe on him. Put a ring on him. Made him look like a ruler. But God had to put him in Egypt with royalty. Y'all not talking to me here. So he can learn how to be a ruler and not just look like it. You know what the problem is in the church? Is that we got persons who look like something that they have not been processed to become. And the reason why persons have to leave and go is because we did not put them up. But when they've been, after they've been processed, too many people get premature promotions. And we got to be learning to discern who people really are. If you can't be willing to get circumcised and get processed, you can't come with me to the promised land. And I need somebody to get it in their minds that if you are not going to be able to walk with me in holiness, walk with me in righteousness, if you can't pray with me, if you can't keep yourself for God and consecrate yourself, you can't come on this ride. The Bible says that bad company corrupts good morals. You need to do a life allocation of your space and make room for what God wants to do in your life. He gets to Potiphar's house. He's tempted. I got 2 minutes. He's in Potiphar's house and everything's going well. But he gets tempted. Tempted people are people who are doing well. Let me help you. I don't need to tempt you when I already got you in chains. So the enemy, God allows the enemy to tempt you to see where your heart is. Joseph, you've been betrayed. You've been hurt. You've been processed painfully. You've seen the favor of God. Now, look at here. You can touch and have anything you want, but this one thing. Will you fall where Adam fell? Will you fall where the men in your families have fallen? There's a reason why Judah's story interrupts Joseph's. And he's dealing with his daughter-in-law and not taking care of the housely duties in his house after his son died. Mm-hmm. And he playing with a prostitute. Y'all don't want to talk to me. And he gets conked. So God wants to see, was my favor enough? Or are you going to take what you think you're entitled to because you've been hurt? And he passes the test. But watch this. She grabs the brothers, stripped him of his robe, put him in a pit that leads to a prison. She took his cloak, naked again, and he's put in prison. The brothers lie. But Potiphar's wife lied too. Somebody say cycle. Sometimes we get frustrated, upset, and look in the mirror, and we blame ourselves for what we're going through. But the cycle, because we're the common denominator, right? But the cycle is not to condemn you. Hey, it's because the cycle is there as an indication that God, I feel him, wants to promote you. The Uber came around again. The same one, lies, stripping. It came around again. Is somebody in here in the cycle? You're in it again because God is getting ready to take you to the next level. Uh-huh. Because there's another house. A greater house with a greater man who has greater responsibilities. You weren't destined to stay at Potiphar's house. So I had to process you and test your heart to get you ready for the next level. And when he got, when lied on, he was put in a prison that positioned him to go to Pharaoh's house. That's when he began to be all that God wanted him to be. And he was positioned over everything to save the lives of the people that needed to be saved. Look at somebody and say, process. God, he looks at his brothers and said, what you meant for evil, God meant it for good. They were scared of Joseph, but Joseph showed them that he was being processed. And I'm here to tell somebody, while you're going through your process, be like Joseph and don't get bitter, but get better. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you're gonna have to forgive your brothers. I know it's painful, but you gotta let your brothers go. You gotta let it go if you wanna go higher. Because the more bags you take, the more it's gonna cost you. You're gonna bleed in your job. You're gonna bleed out in your ministry. You're gonna have character issues. That's why Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. You gotta let them go and recognize that God was using them for his process. You gotta let some sisters go, sisters. Even though they lied on you and told on you, it's just a process. You're gonna have to let some co-workers go. It's just a process. So all you gotta do is continue to remain faithful. Keep your eye
eyes on Jesus. Look at somebody and say, keep your eyes on Jesus, the forerunner, the pioneer, the author and finisher of our faith. If God be for you, who can be against you? Your promotion is here. You've been processed. Look at somebody and tell them, happy graduation. You've been graduating. It's your promotion. It's your time. It's your season. Don't be bitter, but bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. And forget not his benefits when you were in the pits, when you were in the prison, when you were going through, when your mother abandoned you, when your father disappointed you. It was all a part of the process. Don't be ashamed of what you went through. It blessed you and positioned you to be what the Lord wanted you to be. Look at somebody and say, I got joy now. I got peace now. It hurt, but it made me better. It hurt, but it made me stronger. It hurt, but it made me wiser. It hurt, but it helped me with my attitude. It hurt me with my insecurities. And now I can fly high. Say higher, higher. Happy promotion day. The blessing is yours. The promise is yours. Say yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Receive it in Jesus' name. Everyone who can, if you stand. Every head is bowed. Every eye is closed. God has you in the process, and you are being processed for purpose. Process can be painful. Process can be onerous. Process can be difficult, but the process is God intentionally developing you for your purpose. And Jesus, the author and the finisher, the one who has gone before us, has modeled what process is. He endured the cross. He died that you might be able to walk with the Father in your process. He died so that you might have a right to be a son and a daughter of God. He died so that you might be set free. So if you're here right now, my brother and my sister, you find yourself in the process, can I tell you, you need to be connected to the pioneer, the guide, the one who has gone before you. If you're here and you find yourself in a process, you need to have a relationship with the Father through the Lord Jesus Christ. If you're here right now, my brother, my sister, and you do not have a church home, can I tell you, you need to be connected to the brothers and the sisters in the church who can walk alongside you in the process. You don't have to go through it by yourself, but you can have other believers who can encourage you in the Lord. If you're here right now, you need to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, or you need to connect with a place called church. We love to be your church family. We love to support you in your decision today.